where the days are never ending, where the nights are feeling lonely. There's a place that I can go, where the birds are free to roam in the sky. Shine and bright, pushing through the storm tonight. We'll be burning on and on and on. We're the stars inside the sky. We're the last one shining bright, pushing through the storm tonight. We'll be burning on and on and on.
Hello, Sagittarius. This is Inspire 2016 with your weekly tarot reading for the week, commencing the 16th of October until the 22nd of October 2017. The first card for you is representing, how do you feel about yourself? Your card is the Ace of Pentacles. You may see new opportunities come your way to generate a new source of income, or you may be lucky enough to receive a financial gift or windfall. On a broader level, this ace indicates abundance in all areas of your life and a general feeling that you are indeed blessed and deserving of everything that comes your way. Operate by the law of attraction, and send out positive energy into the universe so that you may receive abundance in return. The Ace of Pentacles is about manifestation of your goals, and that you are moving into a more positive state of mind about what you are capable of achieving. Your ideas are ready to be turned into something tangible. Figure out what will work and make it a reality. Thus, the Ace of Pentacles sees you starting to map out how exactly you will achieve your goals, by creating targeted action plans and getting those actions underway. There are opportunities that are becoming available to you that will help you to manifest your goals and realize your inner potential, whilst at the same time generate some level of income and financial support. You are beginning to see that the world is indeed your oyster and that through careful planning, you can manifest your true goals and desires. The Ace of Pentacles can suggest that you need to introduce something new into the equation, rather than let things remain as they are, and hope they work themselves out. The Ace of Pentacles suggests you throw something new into the mix. Consider something that is out of character or something you might not ordinarily do, or get around to doing. For instance, you might consider joining a club, taking a class to learn new skills, or maybe even picking up a couple of books to learn how to build a new business. The second card for you is representing, what do you want most right now? Your card is the Ten of Pentacles. What do you want most right now is reaching a point of completion and accomplishment in your journey. This sense of accomplishment is likely to be as a result of an improved career path, more solid financial reserves, a stable home environment, and a possible committed and long-term relationship. This is one of those cards that shows that everything will eventually come together in a wonderful way and you will feel highly successful and proud of everything you have achieved. You will also feel compelled to share this success with others to ensure that they are also well cared for. With the focus on the family, you may be more inclined to direct a lot of your energy into ensuring that your family has everything that they need, from finances to security and a good home life. You want to ensure that your children and family will always have everything they need. This card shows how family, or even extended family, is incredibly important. It represents tradition, being a part of something bigger and realizing that the blood of your ancestors runs through your veins. It signifies that you are part of a long chain of individuals who subsequently creates a family, a tribe, and a society. It provides structure where you can sit safely and comfortably, knowing that you are a part of history and heritage. The Ten of Pentacles is also a card of affluence and wealth. You are blessed with material abundance and are now free from any sort of money troubles. You feel financially secure and you are fortunate enough to have luck and success on your side to ensure your financial reserves are high. This card reflects permanence and creating a lasting foundation for future success. It is a card of commitment to a sustainable future, taking into consideration not just the short-term benefits of a particular venture but also the long-term benefits. It is about investing in the long term and knowing that you need a consistent approach in order to achieve success that will last the test of time. The third card for you is representing your fears. Your card is the Four of Pentacles. You are afraid of losing money. You are haunted by a fear of poverty that compels you to be materialistic. You are extremely defensive and self-protective materially and emotionally, fearful of opening up and trusting other people. You are very reluctant to spend money and you are keeping a very tight rein on your cash. On the flip side, you may be spending too much money and need to get a better hold of your financial resources. You have spent your time recently focused on career building and material acquisitions, rather than your relationships. This approach to life has been quite successful financially but is very limiting when it comes to connecting authentically with others. You have created a prison for your time and your energy by building up this solid wall of work and financial responsibilities, and will need to release and escape from this to some extent if you want to focus on more personal issues. The important thing to realize is that success in your career is beneficial but only to a point. You may need to examine your life and determine what you can give up, particularly in terms of effort and time put towards work and other similar activities, so that you can have more energy available for developing personal relationships. The Four of Pentacles asks you to loosen your hold on your need for security and stability and step outside your comfort zone. While it will feel a bit shaky at the start, this is an important step in your personal development. The fourth card for you is representing what is going for you. Your card is the Five of Swords. You are engaging in conflict or finding yourself disagreeing with others, leading to tension and hostility. Despite thinking you have won, you may still end up the loser because you have hurt or annoyed others and have subsequently isolated yourself. You try to pick up the pieces and act as if the conflict is now in the past, but others have now lost faith in you and do not want to be around you. This might be one of those times when it feels like everyone is against you and you may lose some friends along the way. You will need to make a decision about whether your point of view is so important to you that it is okay to put your relationship with others in jeopardy, or whether you can compromise and try to see eye to eye with others. If you have been aggressive in your struggles, then you will soon accomplish your objectives. However, if you have been passive, you may need to compromise on your personal interests, giving in to the wishes of the opposing force. You will feel that there are more obstacles ahead, and you will not want to face the ordeal you know you must if you are to have what you want or the way you want it. Overall, you are in for a struggle and there is more work or problems ahead than you are aware of now. Things will not go as well as they should, and you will have conflicts or clashes of will with others. Thus, the Five of Swords is a card representing ambition but in the negative sense. Too much ambition without regard to the consequences to yourself or others results ultimately in a situation of loss for everyone. You may be represented either by the callous winner or the dejected losers. In any case, there is a negative connotation. If your focus is solely on winning your goals at any cost, you will eventually discover to your own dismay that the price of winning may not have been worth the reward. Arrogance and pride often go hand in hand with a difficult triumph such as this, and you must be careful not to think you are invincible. You have overcome a challenge, And you have the right to feel proud, but know that there will be other rivals to face and that some of them will eventually defeat you. Boasting to others that you are invincible is an invitation for someone to prove you wrong. If your victory was won through cheating or unethical conduct, beware of an attempt at vengeance. The Five of Swords can relate to a betrayal or sneak attack by someone you trust and do not suspect as your enemy. There may be an unfaithful partner or a jealous person in your life who is sabotaging you behind your back. Look to other court cards in the reading to understand who may be working against you. You must be very careful whom you trust at this point in time because you are vulnerable to attack and gossip. The advice of the Five of Swords is to pick your battles. You may be tempted to fight every conflict to ensure you get your way, to prove that you are right, or to defend yourself when you are feeling challenged or threatened by another person. However, most experts agree, choosing your battles wisely is a much better way of life than battling out every disagreement. Not only will picking your battles lead to a more peaceful existence, it is also more likely to strengthen your interpersonal relationships. The fifth card for you is representing what is going against you. Your card is the Ten of Swords. There will be a forceful re-evaluation or elimination of your previous attitudes about life, your views about yourself and what is important, and possibly your plans for the future. Despite the initial trauma and torment associated with this change, the imposed re-evaluation can be a very positive thing. It is important to understand that while the means of your demise may not seem reasonable or fair, your previous thoughts and attitudes really need to change in order for you to reach a better place in your life. Rather than dwelling on the painful ending, it is important to look ahead and realize how these events free you up to completely reshape your life and choose a new direction for yourself. The Ten of Swords may also indicate that you are resisting an inevitable ending because you are deeply worried about how much it is going to hurt you. However, what you are doing is delaying the inevitable and possibly making it even worse for yourself because you keep trying to put off something that needs to happen anyway for your own personal transformation. For example, a relationship may have come to an end but you are still intimate with your ex because you cannot bear to let go. This is only drawing out the pain much longer, and it is best to completely let go at this stage. Sometimes, the Ten of Swords may reflect fear of ruin, even if that ruin has not yet occurred. You are always be thinking of the worst case scenario and planning for the worst, even if it does not happen. This is only creating unnecessary fear and anxiety for you, and it is important that you return to the energy of the Nine of Swords and run a reality check as to whether things are as bad as they seem. The Ten of Swords represents an old situation that ended very badly. You are still carrying around wounds from that situation, but you have buried them so deeply that you do not realize they are still present in your life and still hurting you. This old pain needs to be brought up and dealt with once and for all, so you can liberate yourself from these deeply inflicted wounds. It may be difficult to experience the pain again, but at least you are releasing yourself of this pain and allowing it to pass from your life. The last card for you is representing the likely outcome that you may have. Your card is the Seven of Swords. You might be doing something in secret, hoping that you are safe and undiscovered. Something goes awry and your secret is revealed to your embarrassment. This card therefore urges caution when attempting to use cunning or deception to gain an advantage over someone or something else. There is no question that there are times in life when it is necessary to act shrewdly or do something in secret. Perhaps you had to think on your feet and act in a way that was not exactly all above board. Perhaps you had to go behind other people's backs in order to manifest your desires. Perhaps you felt like you needed to cheat or take the easy way out. If acting shrewdly is something you must do, it is essential that you do this with a clear conscience and you are fully aware of the potential consequences of your actions. Taking the easy path is not always the best path, and sometimes you just have to exert a decent amount of effort to achieve what you want. You may be tempted to sneak away from a particular situation that is not working for you anymore, rather than dealing with it head on. As you do not feel ready to deal with the issues, you are aiming for a solution where you can just escape and not have to worry about it all. Are you trying to run away from commitment, responsibility, hard work or love? You may be procrastinating, letting problems slip and become worse because you do not want to deal with them. Sometimes you just have to face what has to be faced. So, the question is this realistic? Will this escape really accomplish what you want to and need to accomplish? Will it address the fundamental issues at hand here? The likely answer is no, and it may simply be an easy way out for now. On the flip side, you also need to be very cautious and wary so that you do not become a victim of someone else's deception, betrayal, cheating and false motives. You may trust someone who then turns out to be running their own agenda, leaving you high and dry. You need to be very careful of who you trust over these coming months as you are at risk of being taken advantage of. Look out for any sneaky behavior and trust your gut instinct about when something does not feel right or is too good to be true. Sometimes, the Seven of Swords indicates a desire to go it alone. You want to discover, investigate and solve every problem using only your own wits and resources. You may believe that you have a better chance at success if you act on your own accord, ignoring the advice or inputs of others. This approach is useful when you need to bypass an ineffectual group or assert your independence, but it can also have its limitations. You may end up feeling isolated and excluded, missing that great feeling of collaboration and synergy gained when you work with others. If you feel inclined to act alone, be sure this isolation will really work for you. Last but not least, the guidance card for you is the Green Gold Dragon from Sirius. Drawing this card suggests you invite these luminous beings to swirl around you, touching your chakras with the sacred geometry of the universe. Then ask them to tune you into any aspect of higher knowledge you can bring forward now. Sit quietly and allow this to happen. You may receive a download of information, or various keys and codes you carry in your soul may light up. If so, you will become a transmitter who broadcasts sacred knowledge, though you may not be consciously aware of it. This is a very powerful dragon, so notice subtle changes in your thoughts and attitudes. Your dreams may reveal memories from your travels with the wonderful green gold dragons from Sirius.
I hope that you enjoy everything, and if you like the reading, just please click subscribe and you will get instant notifications every time we publish a new video right to your YouTube. Thanks.